Gotta say, it's been worth the wait. Here's probably the first Android 8.1 custom ROM for the Mi A1. This is the unofficial Lineage OS 15.1 and it's just spectacular. Starting off with the UI, I'm mind blown. This is super smooth and just flies. Let's just say as smooth as a stock ROM. The launcher has been cleaned up and it's great to see this almost pixel-like app drawer coming from the rather ugly A to Z categorized drawer in Lineage OS 14.1. The Lineage team have also worked on the icons quite a bit and I genuinely find this refreshing. This ROM retains all the Oreo goodness, including this transparent notification panel based on the latest Android 8.1 Oreo. Overall, Lineage OS 15.1 does seem like a refreshing upgrade from its previous version in terms of the design elements. But surprisingly enough, the camera app is still the same as that of the previous Lineage version, and that's a huge bummer. However, we do expect to see a newer version of the app when the official build of the ROM rolls out. But coming back to this old camera app is the usual ugly UI that we've all come to know as the weak point of Lineage OS. There were reports of video recording not working, but that isn't the case for me even though the quality is pure trash. Apart from that, there's the Lineage specific apps like Audio FX, Music and Recorder, which are pretty decent, but I hardly find myself using them. Now let's talk about the performance, and here's where things get slightly disappointing. I've been using the ROM for only a day or so, but in this time period I've downloaded a lot of apps and played some high graphics games, and the results are disappointing. There's a lot of frame drops, making the gaming experience kinda poor. When it comes to opening simple applications, switching between different apps, multitasking, etc., the ROM does a pretty good job. But again, I've been using the ROM for just around a day, so I haven't really tested it out properly. When it comes to battery life, again, it's surely not enough time to test it out thoroughly, but for the time I've been using it, it does seem promising. Either way, I'll update you about the performance and battery life in the comment section in a few more days. Audio quality is great. Volume from both the speakers and the headphones are super loud and clear, so yeah, no issues here. Alright, with that out of the way, let's take a quick dive into the features. Opening the launcher settings, you can edit the grid size and icon pack. And there's also other minor tweaks, including Oreo-specific customization like icon shape and notification dots. Opening the display settings, there's an option for live display, but that doesn't seem to work for now. Then there's an option for choosing a style, and gotta say, this is the feature I've been wanting since I feast my eyes on Oxygen OS customizations. So you can choose between a light or dark theme, but I'd stick with light since the dark theme grays out the settings app instead of giving a dark AMOLED black theme. You can also choose between different accent colors, which is pretty sweet, but I really do wish it also impacted the stock launcher itself. Finally, there's this auto magic option that tunes the style to match your wallpaper. Apart from the style, there are other little but useful features included in the display settings like ambient display and tap to sleep. Tap to wake doesn't seem to work. In the system settings, there's some options for button customizations like long pressing on the power button when the display is off to activate the torch, and some status bar customizations like quick pull down, adjusting brightness by sliding on status bar, etc. There's also a gestures tab, but sadly there's no gesture for swiping down on the fingerprint scanner to open the notification panel, which is a letdown, at least for me, as I use it all the time. Overall, this is one almost perfect ROM that strikes a balance between stability and features, something that Lineage has always been known for. And only if it was for the better performance and enabling a few features, it could very well have been called the best ROM to date. But this is an unofficial ROM, so the cons are justified, or rather, it performs way better than the expectations I had before flashing it. And when the official build rolls out in a couple weeks hopefully, the issues might as well be fixed, making it a treat for all Mi A1 users.